All right. So I muted the computer. The camera's rolling. The volume is up. All right, here it goes. The playing of the record.
Well, line up at just the field and we'll see what will happen here. What is it, what is today and a sacrifice? Who come out talking to Reese or talking to Robinson? They're talking about the best way to pitch the Rockman. Bobby Thomson is off to the right of home plate. First and third off your third, one down. Rockman is the fellow that has to get on. He represents the tying run. Big new stretches. The pitch to Whitey, and he swings and finds and tackles and went for a high fastball. That's the kind of ball that Whitey can hit for distance. It's 4-1 Brooklyn. This is the last of the ninth inning with one out. It's the last of the ninth inning of more respect than you've ever seen. The last of the ninth inning of 1951. Zero with his lead. Alvin Dock doing likewise down the third baseline. The pitch to Whitey. A line throw to face up to left field. Here comes Alvin Dock soon. Don Mueller tries to third. Watson tries to second. Watson is in there. He represents the tying run. And the Dodgers lead by 4-2. Sliding into third. Bobby Rockman doubled into the left field corner. And Bobby Thomson made the giant batter. Don jammed his ankle. Sliding into third, and Doc Bowman is out there. Bobby Rockman doubled over third base. Ducks up and walks out slowly. Bobby Rockman, it was time out, goes over to look at Don Mueller, the boy that the Giants and Giants fans were playing with Mansley. So Bobby Thomson, with a score 4-2, will be batting with runners at second and third. And Rockman at second, one of the fastest of the Giants, will represent the tying run. I've never seen anything like this one in a long, long time. It's something like 100 years, and I've been around for only 99. Mueller seems to avoid himself, and Doc Bowman's working on him. Are they going to bring the stretcher out? Yes, they are. They're going to have to take Mueller out of the game. Eddie Sankey pops down now. Dr. Anthony Palermo, the Giants physician, goes down to look him over, along with Doc Bowman. Mueller seems to be suffering quite a bit. That's really a tough break to have this to happen in the last inning. Well, it might not be the last inning. If the Giants fired up, they'll certainly go on in the stands. But in the last ball game of the year, Don is going to be removed from the field on a stretcher. We did not see him slide into third. I was watching Pasco as he tried to backhand the ball to throw to second base to get locked. And the Dodgers have another conference out there, and Chuck Justin is making up his mind whether to bring in powerhouse Ralph Riker. Well, let's get a couple of eyes. And he is going to make a pitching change. Don Mueller is being carried off the field, and he will get a tremendous ovation from this big crowd at the polo ground. And Ralph Blanco will come in. They're going to put Fred Hartong in the run for Mueller. Hank Jans returns to the bench. And Ralph Blanco makes the long walk from the bullpen. Don Newcomb has come up with a tremendous effort. The Giants have the tying runs at second and third, and they have come up with three hits in this inning. Alvin Dark beat out a hit off the glove of Gil Hodges. Don Mueller singled Alvin Dark to third. Monty Irvin popped to first base. Bobby Rockman, thrilled that he has got his second hit of the day. A line drive double to the left field corner. And Newcomb leads the game. As he leads by a score of 4-2 and Don becomes a losing pitcher. As the tying run are his responsibility. And big Ralph Blanca is in the pitch for Brooklyn. Newcomb walked a total of 8 in the third inning. He's given up a total of 7 giant hits. Newcomb in his time out there struck out 2 men and he walked 2. Mm-hmm.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
So that was side one. Okay, so,
oh my god, it's two sides. That's crazy.
The Giants have a runner on first and third. They're down 4-2. And, we'll find what happens.
Stand is, how does some kid have a reel-to-reel and the teams aren't recording?
Hold that thought, Jeff. Alright, and now for side two.
Against the Brooklyn Club, and hit a lot of the long ones this year. He's got several homers. So don't go anywhere, will you not? Right up to Chesterfield, stay there with us. And we'll see how Ralph Tackle will fare against Bobby Thomson, and then Willie Mays to follow. We'll get a report on Don here, we hope, before the game is over. Jim Herring goes in the bullpen. Jack Lorkey runs down to the bullpen to warm up, indicative of the fact that if the Giants tired and gone to the top of the tenth inning, they'll put Bobby Thomson in the outfield, and Lorkey will play third base. Jim Hearn warming up in the bullpen. He has not appeared in relief this year. Glenn Levine goes in the bullpen along with Carl Urch. And Bobby Thomson is on the biggest spot of his entire baseball career. Bobby, who did not have much minor league experience, has never been involved in the Pennant races yet. This is the biggest spot for him in his entire history. And he'll be up there against Big Ralph Blanco swinging. A home run will win it for the Giants and win the championship. A single to the outfield will more than likely tie up the ball game and keep the inning going. So Leon Rocher comes over and talks to Bobby. The Dodgers lead is 4-2. Willie Mays comes slowly out of the dugout to be the next Giant hitter. Blanco on the spot, he knows it. The big ball from Mount Vernon, New York, with a slight throw, wipes off the perspiration from his brow. And the Dodgers play their infield deep. There's no double play pocket only on a ground ball. Billy Cox, you see. Bobby Thomson will have two out of three. Jim Hearn in the Giant bullpen. Bobby Thomson up there swinging. He's had two out of three, a single or double, and Billy Cox is playing him right on the third base line. Run out, last of the night, Blanco pitches. Bobby Thomson takes a strike call on the inside corner.
Strike one.
Bobby hitting at 292. He's had a single and a double, and he drove in the Giants' first run with a long fly to center. Brooklyn leads at 4-2. Hartung down the line at third, not taking any chances. Watson without too big of a lead at second, but he'll be running back to window. Thomson hits one. Blanco throws. There's a long pass, and Phil B has the lead. The Giants win the pennant. 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 Bobby Thomson hits into the main deck on the left field stand. The Giants win the pennant, and they're going crazy. They're going crazy.
They did. They lost to the Indians.
A vintage record player or a new modern one?
I borrowed it from a friend. I think it's new.
Okay.
but it plays 78s.
Does it have audio out, or is it a built-in speaker?
Built-in speaker.
Does it also have audio out?
It does.
So you can record that onto, did you record it, like, onto something from the audio out or the speaker?